Ebola in America. Now, a lot of you guys have seen this coming, but here we are, September 30th, 2014, and we have the first U.S. case of Ebola on our hands here, right in Dallas, Texas. They're talking about it being a situation where the guy is a male, the patient is a male. He went to Liberia, he came back around the 19th of September, and he began to show symptoms on the 26th of September. Well, obviously he's had 4 days since then. The question is, how long has he been contagious, and how long has he been in contact with other people, and who has he been in contact with? At this point, I hope the CDC is really working with, maybe with other agencies, including the FBI, and really finding these people. Obviously, it's not a criminal case, but you want to use as many resources as you can to find the family and friends who may have had contact with this guy right here in the U.S. and offer free testing, to say the least. Get a hold of these people and see if you can find out who's been affected and who has not been affected. It's not an airborne virus, however, it is spread through very close contact. So that is something worth keeping in mind. I wish the CDC the best of luck. I hope this hospital is able to keep their staff safe, their doctors or nurses safe while they're working on this guy. And I hope they're able to nurse this guy back to health. I wish this guy the best of luck. And I wish everybody involved the best of luck as well, especially the investigators, or people, the staff, the CDC, people who are trying to figure out how this guy was, well, they have a general idea how he got it, but they have to basically look at his history in the last 5 or 6 days, step by step, and figure out where has he been. You know, so and who he actually had contact with. So I wish them all the best of luck. Guys, share your thoughts on this, okay? It's, you know, obviously a very concerning thing, but it's not something worth panicking over. I just want to encourage people to be aware of what's going on. So Ebola in America, how closely are you watching this, and what are your thoughts on this? Do you think there's going to be more infected people in the U.S.? The CDC recently said that there could be as many as 1.4 million people infected, infected with this virus by January 2015. 1.4 million, that's absolutely incredible. We know that the authorities in Western Africa have already been downplaying the amount of people who have been infected and downplaying the amount of people who died because of this virus. So we'll see what happens from here on. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Bye.